guys, in this video we are going to see the two major releases which has been done. Okay, so the first release is, guys, the release of the new Hydra kernels for Android 13, and the second release is the release of the RiseDroid 8.5. okay guys, now this I must tell you that this RiseDroid 8.5 is an official build, as and the Hydra kernel has been built, like it was built today itself. So let's see that what are the changelogs which we are seeing in this Hydra kernel Android 13, and what are the changelogs which we will see in the RiseDroid 8.5. So let's first see the changelogs of the new kernels, which a new kernel which has been released for Android 13. So guys, this is the Hydra kernel. I am here on the GitHub page of the kernel, and here you can see that it is the logo, and guys, it is developed by me and one of my colleagues. So here you can see the my name and all. So here if we talk about more, so here you can see that there are the various devices which are supported. Okay, and here you can find the repositories. Okay, so guys, let's see what are the changelogs which has been done. So for that I will come to the XDA, the official XDA of the Hydra kernels, and here you can see that the changelogs has been stated over here. And guys, here if you see, so there are many changelogs which has been done. The first changelog is, guys, the configuration of the CPU kernels. Now there were total 9 configurations, guys, which I have added in the source. So this is the fun changes which I've done. Now guys, CPU speed, yes, I have pushed the CPU speed. I have set the CPU speed to certain limit if you use the EXT version, guys. If that this all these changes are only applicable in the EXT version. For the basic version, these are not really much. It is more like a stock, but there are some changes for the basic version. Okay, and the XT version, the many additions has been done. So here you can see that the external mouse support has been added. It means that you can connect any external mouse to your mobile phone and you can add it and you can use it, as well as the external keyboard support has also been added. Many times it happens that you want to type something on your mobile phone, but obviously external keyboards, the typing speed is not so much because of the mobile keyboard. So yeah, I mean, in this kernel you can add the external keyboard and you can make use of it. Okay, next thing is the forced enable. I've enabled the forced force fast charge. Now here the thing is that your ROM should support, yes, your ROM should support this thing, because guys, many ROMs it don't support fast charge. Okay, so the kernel will still push the fast charging. Now the next thing is that the fixed desync. Yeah, I mean, see guys, this is a serious problem, because many a times it happens that we are doing BGMI and all, and when you, like, I'm talking about the PUBG Mobile or Battlegrounds Mobile India, any of the gaming and all. So this is only for the XT version, guys, what I'm explaining right now. So many more things has been added. Yes guys, I have added much more things, but all of them cannot be listed over here in just a single changelog. This is the initial release. Now many more release will be there, but guys, this is the initial release, and I hope guys you all will like this kernel. So guys, I am here on the RiseDroid 8.5 changelog. So let's see what are the changelogs which this ROM has done. So now guys, let me tell you that this is the source changelog. This is not a device changelog. Now the difference I've already explained, that source changelogs are from the RiseDroid team, that overall team, and device changelogs is released by the developer. So I don't know whether the device changelog has been released or not, but the source changelog. So let's see what are the source changelogs. So here you can see that many source changelogs has been added. And now I'll just state some of them which I liked. So guys, if I talk about the major changelogs which are done in the RiseDroid 8.5, and guys, let me tell you that this is also an official version of the RiseDroid. So here the four major changelogs has been done. Now the first changelog which I like is the remove excess margin in few status bar icon, because guys, this is a bug which has been fixed. Now next, if we see, so this is the something which is added, the update LTE. So here you can see the, now the most important thing is that guys, allow toggling Netflix spoofing. Now guys, this thing, this problem is faced by many of the people I have seen in the Telegram group. They are like, bro, my Netflix is not working, or that is not detected. So yeah guys, this is one thing which has been fixed. This four is the one which I like the most. Rest all you can read. I'll provide the link of the this changelog in the description. Now let's see guys, from where we can download all these. Okay, and let's see how we can flash this in our Redmi Note 8 Pro. So guys, first thing which you need is the So for that, guys, for the RiseDrawn, you will have to come to this particular website, and here you can see this download option. So you simply have to click on this download. Now let's wait for it. So here you can see that, guys, after clicking on download, you will reach to the kernel file. So for that, guys, directly come over to the XDA page. From here also you can download it. You have to simply come to this XDA page, and here your download has been shown. Okay, so guys, after clicking that link, you will come to this particular page, and here you can see that this Hydra kernel Redmi Note 8 Pro has been released. And guys, and here you can see that, guys, I am currently on MIUI 12.5.5. Now let me just show you. So here I go to the about phone, and here you can see this MIUI version, it is 12.5.5. So guys, if you are on 12.5.5, I mean 12.5.1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 11, 12, 17, 19, whatever you are on, so you can see this video and flash the RiseDroid 8.5 official version, and as well as the Hydra kernels in your RiseDroid. So just what you have to do is you have to click on this MIUI version 7 times. So after clicking on this it 7 times, here you can see that you are now developer has been shown. Now press back button over here and scroll down, and here you can see that there is an additional setting. So you simply have to click on this thing, and here come to developer option, and here when you scroll down, so you'll see that my OEM unlocking, so that is already unlocked. You can see that my bootloader is unlocked. So guys, if your bootloader is not unlocked, so you can simply unlock it. I'll give the link in the I button, and you can unlock your bootloader without the loss of data in the sense like photos and all. So my device is unlocked, so your device should also be unlocked. Now press the back button over here and come over here, and you can see this USB debugging. So you simply have to run this thing and just click on the OK. So I click on the OK over here, and my USB debugging is enabled. Okay guys, now the RiseDroid 8.5 and the Hydra kernels in our Redmi Note 8 Pro. So let me connect my phone to my PC, and let me copy the both of the files. So guys, we have copied the both of the all the three files in our PC, and let me just in our Redmi Note 8 Pro, and let me show you guys that whether it has been copied or not. So I'll come to my file manager, and here you can see that, guys, the first one is the Hydra kernel, which is extended version I have downloaded, and the second file is basically the RiseDroid file, the custom ROM which we are going to flash. So guys, after copying your files, what you have to do is, guys, after copying the files, what you can do is you will have to press the power button, and here click on the reboot and press the volume down button constantly. So guys, here we are on our fastboot mode. Now let's go to our PC, guys, and let's see that how we can flash this custom ROM, okay, and also the custom kernel, that is the Hydra kernel. So first thing what you have to do is you have to click on this theme TWRP recovery, select the WinRAR and click on extract to theme TWRP. Now guys, I've already extracted it, so you will, after extracting, you will get something like a folder like this. Okay, now just simply double click on this, and here you can see that, guys, TWRP theme 3.6.1, there is one more folder, so you simply have to double click on this, and after clicking you will come to this particular folder. Now just simply, guys, double click on this flash BRP MIUI Android 11. Okay, so make sure that your phone is connected, and here you can see that my recovery has been flashed. Okay, now guys, our PC work as of now. So guys, here we are on our phone, and let's wait for the device to reboot to TWRP recovery. So guys, here we are on our TWRP recovery. Now guys, what you have to do is you have to come to over here, click on system and vendor and mount that. Okay, now again press the home button, guys, come to install, and first of all come to wipe, come to advanced wipe, Dalvik system vendor data and cache, and simply swipe to wipe. Now guys, press the home button and come to install over here. So first of all select this RiseDroid and swipe to flash. ROM has been successfully flashed. Now guys, again come back over here and click on this Proton Clang, that is the kernel. So guys, here our custom ROM as well as the Hydra kernel has been flashed. Now guys, what you have to do is you have to press the home button over here, come to advanced, and here select the disable force encrypt. Now guys, this is an important step if you want to do further modifications or further kernel change to your device. If you don't want to do so, you can simply skip this step. Now swipe to wipe. Okay guys, now again, if you want to root your device, so you can simply come to over here, click on the install magisk, and you can root your device. Now guys, I don't want to root it, so I'll simply skip the step. Now come to wipe over here, click on the format editor, type YES and press enter. Okay, now guys, simply click on the reboot system. So guys, our Rise Droid has rebooted. Now guys, simply click on this close and let's get started. So guys, here we are on our Rise Droid, and this looks beautiful. Now guys, let's see whether our kernel has been changed or not. So click on this settings over here. Now guys, scroll down and click on the about, come to the about phone, and here you can see that in the Android version, I guess. So here in the Android version, you can see that our kernel has been changed, and here you can see that this device is officially supported.